Hi children, I am Y. Srinivas, working at JPSS V. Manjar, Penguin Mandal, Commandership. Today, we are going to the lesson Real Numbers. This is your first chapter, Real Numbers. Before going to the lesson, just recap our types of numbers. First, natural numbers. Natural numbers means the numbers starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on are called natural numbers. Generally, natural numbers denoted by the letter N. Natural numbers denoted by the letter N. Next, whole numbers. Whole numbers means starting from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on are called whole numbers. Generally, whole numbers are denoted by the letter W. So, we write W is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on. Since all the natural numbers are in the whole numbers, so N is, we can write N is subset of W. N is subset of W. That means all the natural numbers are in the set whole numbers. All the natural numbers are in the whole numbers. Next, integers. Integers means starting from the 0 to positive numbers. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so on. On the left, we write negative numbers, which are from the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. All the positive and negative plus 0, these numbers are called integers. Integers generally denoted by the letter Z. So, all the whole numbers are in the set integers, all the natural numbers are in the set integers. So, N is subset of Z and W is also subset of Z. That means all the natural numbers are in the set integers, all the whole numbers are in the set integers. So, we can write this as N is subset of W, W is subset of Z. Next, rational numbers. Rational numbers means, before going to define this definition, if you write any FA exam in your class, in any subject, the teacher generally gives you marks as 4 by 10 or 18 by 20, 16 by 20, 17 by 20, all these are rational numbers. In your class, if any subject, the teacher gives your marks as generally 4 by 20. The teacher gives you marks 4 by 20, this is a rational number. Some next student get the marks in maths 18 by 20, this is a rational number. All these which are in the form of P by Q are called rational numbers. Rational numbers. So, we can write any natural number. Let's take 2. 2 can be written as 2 by 1. So, which is in the form of P by Q. So, all the natural numbers are rational numbers. Similarly, if you take whole numbers, let take 0, 0 can be written as 0 by 5, which is equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is also a rational number. Rational number. So, all the whole numbers are rational numbers. If you take any number in a integer, let's say -5. -5 can be written as -5/1. So all the integers are also rational numbers. Generally, rational numbers denoted by the letter Q. Therefore, Q is equal to all the numbers in the form of P by Q are called rational numbers. Therefore, any subset of Q, since all natural numbers can be written as in the form of rational number, so any subset of Q. Similarly, W is also subset of Q, and integers Z is also subset of Q. In general, we can write it as any subset of W, W is subset of Z, Z is subset of rational number Q. Next type of numbers, we take even numbers. Even numbers means 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, so on. If you take any 3-digit number, say 348, its ones place is 8. In any of these, if you take any number, at ones place is 0, that is a even number. If ones place is 8, this is an even number. If ones place is 6, this is an even number. If ones place is 4, this is an even number. If ones place is 2, this is an even number. This is the even number definition. Next, odd numbers. Odd numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, so on. That means if you take any 4-digit number, say 4309. This is a odd number because at ones place in any of these numbers, that is a odd number. If ones place is 3, 3 is here, therefore this is a odd number. If ones place is 5, this is an odd number. This is the definition of the odd number. Next, prime numbers, which is the most important type of numbers. Prime numbers means if you take any number, here I take 5. 5 can be written as in the factors of 1 into 5 only. 5 can be written as product of the factors as 1 into 5 only. Therefore, 5 is a prime number. Here I write below 50 prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29. That means in between them they are composite numbers. So, next 31, 37, 41, 43, 47, so on. Below 100, there are 25 prime numbers. How many numbers are there below 100? 25 prime numbers. All these numbers can be written as the product of 1 and itself. 1 and itself only. If you take here 41 can be written as 1 into 41 only. If you take another number 19, we can write 19 as 1 into 19 only. Therefore, all these are prime numbers. Therefore, prime numbers means a number which can be write in the product of 1 and itself. Itself means that number is called prime numbers. Other than prime numbers are called composite numbers. Again, this is the also important definition. Composite numbers means other than prime numbers. from 1 to 100, I write here some prime numbers. Other than prime numbers are all composite numbers. Here 4 is the least composite number. Here already we take 2 and 3 are prime numbers. So next number is starts from 4. 4 is the least composite number. Remember, 0 and 1 are neither prime nor composite. Remember, students, 0 and 1 are neither prime numbers nor composite. They does not belong to any of these. So composite numbers starts from the number 4, next number 6, and next number 8, so on. So remember, least composite number is 4. Next definition, prime factorization. Prime factorization means, if you take any composite number, that can be written as product of prime factors, product of prime numbers. Here I take the composite number 12. 12 can be written as 2 into 6. Again, 6 is a composite number, so 6 can be written as 2 into 3. Therefore, 12 is equal to 2 into 3. This is the prime factors of 12. 12 is equal to 2 into 3. Another composite number I take here, 26. 26 key can be written as 2 into 13. Therefore, this is a prime number and 13 is also prime number. So we cannot factorize these two numbers. Therefore, 26 is equal to 2 into 13. This is the composite number that can be written as product of prime numbers. Next, students, we are going to the lesson. The first concept is how to represent a rational number or two rational numbers, three rational numbers on the number line. Here I take a rational number which is 3 by 4. He asked the question like this: represent 3 by 4 on number line. 3 by 4, which is a proper fraction. This is 3 by 4 is a proper fraction because denominator is greater than the numerator. Therefore, all the proper fractions, lies between 0 and 1, or if the rational number is negative, lies between 0 and minus 1. All the proper fractions lies between, if it is 0, if it is a positive rational number, that lies between 0 and 1. If it is negative proper fraction, that lies between 0 and minus 1. So 3 by 4 is a positive rational number which is a proper fraction, so that lies between 0 and 1. So how to represent this proper fraction on number line? Observe this. Here in the denominator is 4. So I draw a line, number line. I represent at center as 0. I divide every unit equal units 1, 2, all are same units, distance. Their distance between is same units. So from 0 to 1 I divide 4 equal parts. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a proper fraction. So this is lies between 0 and 1 because this is a positive rational number, lies between 0 and 1. Here the given rational number, the denominator is 4, so we divide 0 to 1 into 4 equal parts. If the denominator is 3, we divide into 3 equal parts. This is the reminder, remember to represent a rational number on the number line. What is the denominator here? 4. So we divide into 4 equal parts. So this is equal to 1 by 4. This is equal to 2 by 4. This is equal to 3 by 4. This is equal to 4 by 4. That is equal to 1. What number here he asked? 3 by 4. Therefore 3 by 4 is here. This is the number line representing on number line. This is the rational number representing on the number line.
Stop.
Next students, how to represent 5 by 3 minus 5 by 3 on number line. Here I take two rational numbers. How to represent 5 by 3 minus 5 by 3 on number line. Now I draw a number line which is 0 here, on right positive integers, on left negative integers. I take equal distance, each unit is equal distance. To represent 5 by 3 on number line, which is a, here 5 by 3 is a what fraction? This is improper fraction. This is a improper fraction. This is a improper fraction. That means this number is other than 1, lies between 5 by 3. Here denominator is 3, so we divide every unit into 3 equal parts. We divide every unit 1, 2, 3. I divide every part into 3 equal parts. 1 to 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. This is 4. Similarly on left, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I divide every unit into 3 equal parts. On right side, that means on positive side, on negative side. Now 5 by 3. Before represent this 5 by 3, we write down the parts as, here it is equal to 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 3 by 3, 4 by 3, 5 by 3, 6 by 3. 6 by 3 means here is 2, 3 by 3 means here is 1. Next number, this is equal to 6 by 3. Next, 7 by 3, 8 by 3, 9 by 3, which is equal to 3, so on. Similarly, on left, minus 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, minus 3 by 3, which is equal to minus 1. This is equal to minus 4 by 3, this is equal to minus 5 by 3, -6/3, which is equal to -2. Next, this part equal to -7/3, -8/3, -9/3, which is equal to -3. Part numbers you have to represent on number line. 5/3. Where is 5/3? Here it is. Here it is. -5/3 on left, which is -2. Here it is. This is the rational numbers, given rational numbers are representing the on number line. 5/3 here, -5/3 is here. Next, students, I take a rational number as a improper fraction, 19/5. Here I take the rational number 19/5. How to represent 19/5 on this number line? How to represent 19/5 on the number line? Since 19/5 is a positive rational number, so we can draw the number line only on positive side is enough. No need of negative side. So I not take here minus side. I start from here. 0, 1, 2, 3, which are in the same distance, equal units. I divide this number line equal distance. Now, what number is the rational number? 19/5, which is a improper fraction. 19/5 is a improper fraction. Improper fraction. Improper fraction. How to represent this improper fraction on this number line? So, what we do? Every unit divides into how many parts? Here denominator is 5, so 5 parts. Every unit divided into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I divide every unit into 5 equal parts because their denominator is 5. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now write down every part as this is equal to 1/5, 2/5, 3/5, 4/5. This is equal to 5/5, which is equal to 1. Next, 6/5, 7/5, 8/5, 9/5. Next, 10/5, which is equal to 2. Next number, 11/5, 12/5. 13/5, 14/5, this is equal to 15/5, 15/5, which is equal to 3. So, we have to extend this line up to 4. This 4 should be divided into 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5.
And
5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is 4. This part equal to 16/5, 17/5, 18/5, 19/5. Here is the rational number. 19/5 is there. That means this improper fraction lies between 3 and 4. Here is the rational number. Required rational number is here, 19/5. So students, remember how to represent a rational number on number line. First, we observe the denominator. By denominator, using every unit into divide equal parts. Here is 5, so every unit divide into 5 equal parts. If the denominator is 3, we divide every part into 3 equal parts. Students, next concept is to find rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. How to find rational numbers between any given two rational numbers? By using mean method. Mean means, we have to define here, mean. You have to know about the mean. Mean means sum of observations. Sum of observations by number of observations. Sum means adding. Number of means, given how many numbers are there? 2. We take here any 2. So by 2. If the numbers are P and Q, their mean is equal to P plus Q by 2. Their sum is P plus Q. How many numbers are there? 2. P plus Q by 2. Therefore, this definition is called mean method. We are using here mean method. In mean method, how to find the rational numbers? Here I take the numbers 3 and 4. Here I take the numbers 3 and 4, two rational numbers. I write 4 rational numbers in between them. I write here 4, I insert 4 rational numbers in between them by using mean method. First rational number. Rational number between 3 and 4 is equal to, by using mean method, how to find the rational numbers in between them, 3 and 4? 3 plus 4 by 2, that is equal to 7 by 2. 7 by 2 is the rational number in between them. That means, if you take the rational number 3 and 4, here it is 7 by 2. This is the rational number lies between 3 and 4. Next, we find another rational number in between 3 and 7 by 2 or 7 by 2 and 4. We take any two rational numbers. Here I take rational number between 3 and 7 by 2. Now, I find rational number in between them, 3 and 7 by 2, by using mean method. Is equal to, what to write? 3 plus 7 by 2 by 2. Sum of these two numbers by 2. This is the mean definition. How to write 3 plus 7 by 2? How to add with this? 2 into 3, 6 plus 7, 6 plus 7 by 2 by 2. 6 plus 7 is equal to 30 by 2 by 2, which is equal to multiply the denominator by denominator 4. This is the rational number in between them. Here it is, 13 by 4. Next, I find a rational number between 7 by 2 and 4 by 2. I find rational number between 7 by 2 and 4. Children, how to find this rational number in between 7 by 2 and 4? 7 by 2 plus 4 by 2, that is equal to, how to add this rational number and integer part? 2, 4 is 8, 7 plus 8 by 2, by 2, this 2 is this is equal to 15 by 2 by 2, which is equal to 15 by 2 into 2, 4. This is the rational number in between them, 15 by 4. How many numbers I find in between 3 and 4? 1, 2, 3. We can find some more rational numbers in between 3 and 13 by 4 in the same manner. 13 by 4 and 7 by 2, 7 by 2 and 15 by 4 in between rational number, 15 by 4 and 4. If you take any two rational numbers, you can find a rational number in between them. Students, I find one more rational number in between. I take here 13 by 4 and 7 by 2. 13 by 4 and 7 by 2, in between these two rational numbers, I find one rational number, right here. Next, fourth point, rational number between 13 by 4 and 7 by 2. 13 by 4 and 7 by 2. How to find rational number between them? That is equal to 13 by 4 plus 7 by 2 by 2. Sum of these two rational numbers by 2. How to add these two rational numbers? LCM of 4 and 2 is 4. 4 in 4, 1 time, 1 into 13, 13 plus 2 into 2, 4. So 2 into 7, 14. 1 by 2, which is equal to 27 by 4 by 2, which is equal to 27 by 4 to 8. This is the rational number in between 13 by 4 and 7 by 2. Here it is. 27 by 8 is the rational number between 13 by 4 and 7 by 2. Students, practice the same process, you can find so many rational numbers. Remember students, between any two rational numbers, how many rational numbers are there? Infinite numbers of rational numbers you can find here. So I find how many numbers are? 5, 27 by 8. This is the required rational numbers between 3 and 4. 3 and 4. Students, I take same rational numbers 3 and 4. I take here same rational numbers 3 and 4 by using another method, how to insert 8 rational numbers between 3 and 4? By using another method, which is we call this as our second method, insert 8 rational numbers between 3 and 4. How many numbers insert? Insert 8 rational numbers. Therefore, we take 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. That means 3 is equal to, we take 3. 3 can be written as 3 by 1. We multiply 3 by 1 by 3, 9 by 9, which is equal to 3 9 ja 27 by 9. Similarly, 4 can be written as 4 by 1. We multiply by 4 by 1 by 9 by 9, which is equal to 36 by 9 by 9. Students, observe this. What we call this method is second method. Insert 8 rational numbers between 3 and 4. How to insert 8 rational numbers between 3 and 4 by using second method, what we call is second method. We add 8 plus 1, that is equal to 9. 3 is equal to, take 3, because we have to write rational numbers in between these two numbers. We take 3, 3, 3 can be written as 3 by 1, multiply by 3 by 1, by 9 by 9, which is equal to 27 by 9. Similarly, 4, 4 can be written as 4 by 1, multiply by 4 by 1 by 9 by 9, 4 9s 36, 1 to 9, 9. Therefore, here 3 equal to 27 by 9 and 4 equal to 36 by 9. To insert 8 rational numbers, we write down here, 27 by 9, next number, 28 by 9, 29 by 9, 30 by 9, 31 by 9, 32 by 9, 33 by 9, 34 by 9, 35 by 9, 36 by 9. Between given these two numbers, I insert 8 rational numbers. Count down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which are required 8 rational numbers. These are the 8 rational numbers by using second method randomly. This is the process, another process. We already discussed about the mean method, that is the first method. Sometimes in question paper asked using mean method, if he asked mean method, we must do that process. Without using mean method, find 8 rational numbers or 10 rational numbers, we use this method. Insert 8 rational numbers means 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. Multiply by 3 by 9, similarly 4. We multiply it like this. Then in between them, we write down the rational numbers as like this. 27 by 9, 28 by 9, 29 by 9, 30 by 9, 31 by 9, 32 by 9, 33 by 9, 34 by 9, 35 by 9. Then the 36 by 9 means, which is equal to here 4, 9 4s. Here 27 by 9 means 3, 3 and 4. Insert 8 rational numbers. This is the students. Next students, insert, if you ask five rational numbers. Insert five rational numbers between -3/4 and 1/4. Here I take two rational numbers as -3/4 and 1/4. How many numbers you insert? Five rational numbers. How to insert five rational numbers in between them? So we take 5 + 1 = 6. We multiply this these two rational numbers by 6/6. Therefore, -3/4 = -3/4 × 6/6, which is equal to 3 × 6, 18. -18/4 × 6, 24. Similarly, 1/4 = 1/4 × 6/6, which is equal to 1 × 6, 6. By 4 × 6, 24. Come write down. Here, -18/24. Here the number is 6/24. How many numbers we insert in between them? Here 5. So write down. This is the negative. This is the positive. So reduce 1 by 1. -17/24. Next, -16/24. -15/24. -14/24. -13/24. -12/24. So on. Next number means -11/24. Next, last, you find here 0/24. Next number is 0/24. Next number is 1/24. Next number is 2/24. 3/24. 4/24. 5/24. 6/24. Which is equal to, this is equal to 1/4. Given a rational number. This is equal to -3/4. Which is given rational number. In between them, I write here approximately 10-15 rational numbers. But here he asked 5 rational numbers only. This is the second method how to find a rational numbers between any given two rational numbers. Students, today we discussed two concepts which are, first, initially we discussed about the representing the rational numbers on number line, representing the rational numbers on number line. Another concept is how to insert rational numbers in between any two rational numbers. How to insert rational numbers in between any two rational numbers, which are two methods. First method is by mean method, and second method is multiply the denominator method. These two methods are discussed, and initially we discussed about the number line, representing the rational numbers on number line. Dear students, in our textbook exercise number 1.1, from problem number 1 to 5, you practice all these questions what we discussed earlier are the in this exercise here. So students, this is your worksheet. Take this as worksheet. Exercise number 1.1, problem number 1 to 5. If any doubts, ask your teachers. Dear students, tomorrow we will discuss some more problems and a concept. Okay, students? Okay.